Okay, the last time I already showed my holder for bikers holder that you can see here, I explained it, why I use it, how I use it, and all of its features. So I think it's not necessary to go on with the features again. So I would like to show you how to install just the mobile inside the holder and what I do to fix it. So of course you have your mobile here. You just press it down, open up the holder. Press it inside, it makes click, and you turn it around. And right now it's locked because this latch is not able to move anymore. For secure, I put some hook here, and of course you can throw it around your GPS bar. So even if your holder is failing, in the end your mobile won't end somewhere in the grass and or in the woods where you have to search it and. In the worst case, you won't find it anymore. So, yeah, I could recommend like putting some luck around. So this one came with the mobile. This one I bought cheap on Amazon, I have to admit. Yeah, maybe it's already or as well Chinese. Yeah. But this is the position. Of course, my windscreen is right now dismounted. I dismounted it the last time in the video and showed you how fast it is to remove it. And yeah, this one is the final position. I don't put any what it's called here, this charging plug inside because of the reason that I told you. Otherwise, you could also use like the USB port down here, which comes with a F5 fairing. Yeah. So right now this one is the final position, how I start my tour. And yes, right now I would like to show you how I control my mobile device from my handlebar. So yeah, let's first talk about my controller that I use. And as you can see down here on the left side of my handlebar, I use the Capoeira Terrain Command 2. And this one is I think this were like 40 millimeters. So you have to think about that you have to have 40 millimeters of space here on your left handlebar if you want control all the buttons with your left hand. I already saw that some guy were like mounting one set of buttons on the left side and the other one on the right handlebar. So in my case, it was possible to mount them or to put them both on the left side. Because of course on the right side is the gas hand, and I don't like to use any buttons with my gas hand. But think about to have 40 millimeters of space here, and that you maybe have to move your light and turning signal unit over here a lot. So I also have had to turn it a lot. And I already use the short clutch lever, and it of course becomes even more short. But for me, it was quite okay because if you look from here, so I can just use it with two fingers. I like to have a two-finger clutch and have the fingers free on the handlebar and only use a clutch with two fingers. So this is quite good for me. So 40 millimeters were not a problem, but on some bikes it could be a problem, and I didn't like it to have on the right side. Yes, exactly. So this unit also have some Bluetooth adapter, and the Bluetooth adapter is not within these buttons here. The Bluetooth adapter is a single unit. It's like a 3D printed unit with electronics inside, and this is shockproof and looked very sturdy and also like glued completely so that no water can get inside. I put it behind this plastic here. So if you remove this plastic with the four bolts, it's very fast. Back here you have this toolbox. There's a standard toolbox or stock toolbox from Husqvarna and KTM. And I don't carry anything here inside. So I put the Bluetooth device here inside and wired the both cables, which come from the controllers down to here. Connected it to the Bluetooth box, and I connected the Bluetooth box to the battery, of course, with some fuse, and put some switch in between so that I can switch the Bluetooth device on and off. The Bluetooth device doesn't drain that much milliamps, so it's like a very low current. But anyway, it will drain it, and I don't like to drain my my battery when my bike is standing, so I just put the switch in between. So yeah, like I just showed you, I can turn on and off the Bluetooth device from here, and this one will get connected to my mobile that I will show you right now. So when your Bluetooth device is powered on and your mobile is like this, of course you can unlock it with your glove, you open up the home screen, and yeah, it's already connected because it's Bluetooth. You just set it up one time, and as you can see here, this one has a depending app. It's called Controller, and if you open this one up, you can also see that it's the Capitec Terrain command. You can that's a little bit, okay, configure it. You can test, for example, the buttons, and you will see, of course, if I press up, it's up, down, left, right, zoom in, zoom out, right, the HUD, the head-up display, and the enter select button. So all keys are working. This is okay for me. So I want to switch over to drive mode dashboard. Okay, wait, I will show you the setup of the keys one more time from here. So this one is like up, this one is the down button. This one is a left button, this one is a right button, this one is a zoom in button, this one is a zoom out button, the HUD button, and the enter button. So yeah, these are the 8 buttons right now and how they are configured. Okay, so I would like to open up my drive mode dashboard. I of course double click on the top of my mobile, and yeah, it's already running. So I try to find the best angle from where it doesn't glare too much. I think you can see it from here. Okay, and I'm already able to control my mobile device from my handlebar. So as you see, I just entered the mode. I can go to the left and right. I can go to the bottom side, and of course with my controller I can choose a depending app that I wanted to start up. And I also can exit with a button on the bottom right. So with a button on the top right, I can enter the menu. I can scroll down, and as I can scroll up, I go to the left and right. And I can as well exit the menu again. So what's the reason for exiting the menu is because I also can scroll down to this menu on the bottom side, of course. And as you see, I can choose my roadbook, and I can enter the roadbook mode if I press the enter button for longer. And now the roadbook mode is on. So nothing else can happen with my mobile. I won't switch the app, I won't go to the left or right. Instead, I can, of course, scroll my roadbook up and down, follow the waypoints. I can also set the trip meter, correct the trip meter, the total one or the part one. And I see, of course, a cap. And this is quite fun. So I don't have to remove my hand from the handlebar. Instead, I can scroll it from here. I see all the navigation points. I can write while I'm standing. I can go to the next points, correct my trip meters, and this is very, very nice. As you just saw, the use of the roadbook is of course pretty easy. You can quit the roadbook mode when you press enter a longer time, and then you are able again to move to your different screens on drive mode dashboard. And for example, okay, you want to choose right now Google Maps. You press enter and press enter again, and you are in Google Maps. And you can of course go to the left and right. You can zoom in and zoom out by hand. You can go up and down, and if you lost your position, you press one button and it will okay, this one's wrong. This was the home screen. Okay, so I messed it up. I want to start Google Maps again. Zack. And I want to go to my position. I can just go back to my position, you see. I go more to the left side, to the Netherlands, and back again to my position. I won't zoom in that much because then you know exactly my position and I don't need to share it on the internet. But yeah, just the main functions, up, down, left, right, zoom in, zoom out. And of course you can change the direction of the map. So if you are following yourself, so that the map will move with your direction, or that the map will like is getting fixed to the north and that you go like this. So for me it's very easy to handle it from the handlebar, to you control it from the handlebar. And in my case, what I use very much is I ride on like the 200 meter zoom. So for me it's quite comfortable. I don't know why I use it. For me it's the best. So but if I want to see what's in the distance, yeah, you know, I just click two times and I zoom out to the 1 kilometer scale or even 2 kilometer scale, and I see, okay, the next 2 or 3 kilometers on my track there's nothing happening. So I can ride, relax the next 2 kilometers, and as well I can zoom in, of course, again, like the 200 or 200 or 200 meter resolution. And so this is what I use yeah, most often. So zoom in, zoom out, to see what's upcoming on the track. And so you see, for the Roadbook navigation as well as for kart navigation on different apps, it's quite amazing to have some controller like the Carpeeta terrain command, or even other ones that I just want to talk about later. Okay, one more feature, of course, of the controller is the HUD. So this one is a HUD button, and you press it like once, and your HUD is showing up. So you see, you have like 8 different options on the screen of your mobile. On the left side, of course, you have 8 buttons. So every button or every option is according to one button. And you can, yeah, for example, choose a volume. You can raise and lower the volume. You can mute the volume directly if you have some headphones inside. You can go back. You can raise or lower the brightness of your display if you go by night riding or it's very bright daytime and you wanted to have it as bright as possible. And of course you go back every time here. You have some media, so you can screenshot it. But also one feature that I use very often is up here, so that you can disable the touch. And this has a reason that if you are riding while it's raining, all of these raindrops will do some interferences on your screen. So it your mobile will think you touched anything, and it will move to the left and right sometimes and do some weird stuff that it's not doing when you disable the touch screen, so that it's only possible to use your control buttons. And this is very helpful. Then you can go back to your home screen again. Yeah, you can double click it again, so you come back to Drive Mode Dashboard. And yeah, this is how I navigate or use my navigation and control buttons with my mobile device. And yeah, there are some alternative controllers that I want to talk about right now. Okay, so this one, like I just told you, is a Carpeeta Terrain Command 2. Carpeeta has 2 of these controllers in the program or in the line. So this one is a heavy duty version. There's another version. It's maybe more for adventure riding and for street riding. So the other controller is a little bit smaller. It doesn't have 8 buttons. It doesn't have such a big casing. Instead, it has some control stick that you can move to the up, down, left, and right, and 2 buttons. And it's some very small unit, and you can yeah, just like put it on your mirror, for example, with a clamp. And of course, I lost the 40 millimeters here, so if it's more like here, you can also control it on the mirror from the mirror, and this one has a big advantage that you don't have the additional Bluetooth device which I fit in here. Instead, this small device has a battery inside, and it's not like the battery will only last like for a few days or a week. No, it will last, I think, or I've been told that it will last for a few months. So half a year you have to change the battery, and you don't need to connect anything else. You just put it on your mirror and connect it via Bluetooth, because the Bluetooth controller is inside, and you don't have to put any wires or cables to your battery or to some controller anywhere else, and you're ready to go. The disadvantage of the system is that the control stick, so this is what I have been told, is not very flimsy, but of course here you have like 8 buttons with a very clear pressing point. And if you have some small controller with a small control stick, in hard terrain it can be that this control stick is not like acting very very well. So it's maybe that you do some moves that you move or scroll down too far, like on a roadbook for example, that you can feel the exact touching point or the acting point of the control stick. But this is only like on very hard terrain, so I choose a heavy duty version because I would like to attend some events in the future which are on harder terrain, and so I went for this one. And I don't like the battery, also in my opinion it's like I want to have the power all the time. I don't like to ride and then recognize that the battery is empty, but okay, this will last for like half a year, so I think this won't happen that often. But I want to have this clear pressing point. I don't want to have some more or less flimsy control stick. No, 8 buttons are okay for me. And yeah, so I chose the heavy duty version. There's the other version for adventure and lighter off-road riding. Let's call it like this. Yeah, it depends how you want to talk about this topic. Everybody has a different opinion what is hard and softer off-road riding, and yeah. But you can choose this one. This one is more cheap. I don't know the exact prices right now. This was approximately, I think, 350, 380. And the smaller one is like 200 euros, I guess. Yeah, but you can check it out on the homepage. One more important information is that both controllers are only working with Android, and you have at least Android 7 or higher to use them. It won't work with the iOS system as far as I know. And so just keep in mind that it's that you need some Android. I have some iPhone XR anyway. I couldn't use my mobile for navigation then. Maybe they will change it in the future. You should check out their homepage. I think it's like just Google Carpe Ita and you will get to the homepage. Maybe they have already some news which versions are supported or which systems are supported. They have, of course, the apps which are supported shown on the homepage, and you can have a look there. And this one is a cheaper option, yeah, from Carpe Ita that you can put here, or you use the heavy duty version as I did and put it here, and as well install this Bluetooth device over there. The last option that you have if you want to control your bike with a controller is I just got to know from a colleague of mine that some South African colleague more or less, so some African guy developed some kind of controller by himself. So I think you can check on Rally Rampage. I will also put the link down below. So you have the option. You have the option that he will build it for you. This casing will be some 3D printed casing and some waterproof buttons here inside. You can ask him to build one, and as well ask him or choose the option that you get all this necessary files to build it by yourself. So you get some STL files to do a proper 3D printing for this controller here, and also some small casing where the controller is inside, the Bluetooth controller. You will get the part list of the items that you need to purchase. You will as well get the wiring diagram and the program itself that you have to put on the Bluetooth controller and to program it. So this one is, as far as I know, the most cheapest version. You can do it by yourself. It's approximately, I think, with the parts. So a colleague of mine just did it and it worked. And it was like 70 euros in total for all the different parts. So right now I can show you some pictures what it looks like. And as you see, so this one is of course self-made, but he also showed me some videos and it's working. So it's, I don't know if it works with Drive Mode Dashboard. Instead it's here, it's working with a Rally navigation app. So you can control your roadbook, your digital one, of course, with a self-made controller, as well as different navigation apps like Guru, Google Maps, and so on. You can also control, like I just did with this one. And I think this is some very cheap option, and also for some guys which are planning to have a controller but don't like to spend that much money and are also capable of doing it by themselves. It's a very nice, a very nice option to do. So okay, overall I would like to mention that this is my kind of solution for navigating. There's not the best kind of solution. I think everybody has their own needs and will know what they want and what they need. In my case, I like it that it's very far in the front and very high up, so that I can see it better. I didn't show the pivoting option. So if you like riding in standing position on the footpegs, you can lift the device so that you have a straight angle to your display, and of course you can move it back again so that you have a slightly lower angle to your display. And of course, as I said, there's not the best solution. This is my solution. Maybe you liked it, maybe you did not, and if you didn't, just tell me. Maybe you have also some tips for me. You can just put them down below inside the comments. But hopefully I could maybe help you a little bit with what I use and what suits for me best right now. And thanks a lot for watching. I hope the weather will get better within the next day so that I can take some small rides again. Yep, ride safe, have fun, and see you next time.